The concepts arising in consciousness about itself is called world. That pure consciousness or awareness is called Narayana. Narayana himself is the sole reality. There is no other reality. So when you are actually Narayana himself takes all the forms of all the world and body and everything, and he himself becomes a living being. We call Narayana or Shiva. So to explain this world and all, then you need to bring in some concept called Maya, duality, avidya and all. In reality, only consciousness. Mind of Allah. Brahma Udra. Indra. Indra, Master of Control. All living beings. All rulers of the world, all divine beings arise from Narayana. They all live in Narayana. They merge in Narayana. Narayana is Brahma, is Narayana. Shiva is Narayana. Indra is Narayana. Sense organs. All plants are Narayana. All directions are Narayana. Top is Narayana. Bottom is Narayana. Inside your shell is Narayana. Everything what present, past, future. Nirvikalpa. Thoughtless, nirakara, that's awareness. One who knows this emerges Narayana. Everything is Narayana, the pure consciousness. So you are thinking that you are a living being, you are individual. No, you are a dream character in Narayana. You are a dream girl. You think you are dreaming Maya. No, you are in the dream. So you think that I am dreaming Maya is my dream. No, you are a dream character in Narayana's dream. And who is the dreamer? You think I am dreaming, I am suffering. The Narayana is the dreamer. The The body is Narayana. The earth is Narayana. The space is Narayana. Everything is Narayana. Consciousness.
So, does consciousness awaken to itself from its own dream?
Self knows itself. When self tries to see itself, the world arises.
Hmm.
When self knows,
it's a dream.
When so, self knows itself, freedom. So when self knows itself that this is a dream, it is freedom. Self tries to see itself, then the world arises in itself. Our world appears in itself, rather, that's the right word. Okay, so it wanders and tries to find out and experience something, all those things. Finally, it says, okay, it's not worth it. Then let me know myself. Then self knows itself. Then the world becomes a concept which is not there. Self alone is there. In the beginning there was self, in the middle there was self, in the end there is self. So you people, we are thinking that, oh, I am suffering and all. No. So your concept of I am is the suffering. There's only universe, there's only consciousness. So what you call as I am, what is that? Tell me, what is it you are calling I am? So I am suffering because of my boss. Okay? So that is a role you are playing in the office. The role is not you. That's a transaction. The role suffers. But the one who is playing the role doesn't suffer. So you have to understand this in terms of film actor. Like Amitabh Bachchan plays the role of a beggar. Amitabh Bachchan plays the role of a thief. And when he plays the role of thief, somebody beats him. So, nothing happens to Amitabh Bachchan. He is playing the role. Like that, the consciousness, nothing is happening. The role is being played. So, when you say, I am suffering, it's only the role, specific role. The I cannot ever suffer. I can never suffer. I is the knower. How can knowing suffer? I am trapped inside the body. How can consciousness be trapped in the body? Body is in consciousness.
So I am is also still a concept.
I am also is a concept. So the I am concept comes into picture. Actually, I am concept is the root of the concept, root of the world.
That's the beginning of the individual.
That's the beginning of the world. So the I am in Sanskrit is called aham. Okay? Aham means I am. Aham is actually abbreviation in Sanskrit called akara, hakara, makara, aham. So that is equivalent of in English, A to Z is called aham.
Beginning and middle.
A is beginning. Sanskrit, first alphabet is akara. Makara is the end alphabet. Aham, hum. Okay, so A to Z in the world is called aham. Your ego appears as A to Z in the world for you. And same thing is true for other person's ego. So whether other person exists or you don't know. Only from your point of view, from consciousness within you, projects becomes the aham, which means everything in the world. And in that aham, one object is body. So that identification is the one object called ahankara. Ego. Whereas every object in the universe is aham only. That aham takes the shape of every object and name of every object. That's why it's called A to Z. So that's called Shakti. Consciousness is called Shiva. This is called Shakti. The Shakti takes all the form. Where is the individual? Tell me. Individual is a concept in the many millions of objects. One object is called I, me. So that also, I am body will not be there for all the time to you. So sometimes I am the body. You become, when the man sees woman, he becomes the body. then when he says I am feeling, he becomes the mind. You are not the body. So you have illusion that I am a body somewhere. Not all the time you are a body. When your attention shifts to the mind, you have become mind. When your attention shifts to intellect, you become the intellect. When your attention shifts to Atma, you become the Atma. So, but we still feel the I am body. How can you feel like that? You change. Attention can only go to one thing. So you become body sometimes, you become mind sometimes, you become intellect sometimes. Still I am stuck with the, I am identifying with body. How can you do that? I am identifying with body is another thought, which has no reality with other thoughts. Because that thought, I am the body, the thought was there for a moment, it went, disappeared. I am mind thought came. Then I am the intellect thought came. Then you say, I am body, I am stuck to the body. I am identifying with the body. How can you identify the body here? That I am identifying with the body is another thought, which has no relationship to other thoughts. Only consciousness is there. The consciousness is inside, outside, everywhere, and that alone is God. See, Atmajnana means realizing that God alone is the reality. What I call as individual I is not, is illusion. It was never there. See, in yoga they say individual merges with the universal. To merge with the universal, there should be individual should be there. I am suffering, look at yourself, what are you suffering? Oh, I am suffering because my husband is shouting at me, my boss is shouting at me. That's a role. The I never suffers, which is consciousness. And what I call a suffering is not suffering, it's a pain. Okay, momentarily there is a pain. And that pain you keep on recollecting, which is thoughts, and say I am suffering. The thoughts are always from the past, which has no reality.
But is it a matter of habit that I keep identifying with the role rather than with the I?
It is. See,
because there is, at least during the waking state in the transaction, as a forgetful.